Good morning and welcome to St. John's Cathedral. We're so pleased that you've joined us for worship this morning. Whether you are a longtime member of our congregation, a fellow Christian on the journey, or if you are a spiritual explorer who just comes to this space this morning to rest with us in this time of prayer, we're glad that you're with us and we welcome you to be part of this community this morning with us digitally. A few announcements before we begin. We're starting next Sunday with the first week in our adult vacation Bible school. This year we're going to be exploring St. Paul's wonderful epistle to the Romans, and we're going to be doing that for several weeks, and so we invite you to come at 9:30 next week to join us for our first in our conversations on St. Paul's letter to the Romans. This coming Tuesday, July the 7th, our social witness committee is once again going to meet. We invite members of our community to join us on this My St. John's Facebook page for that meeting. This evening, we celebrate the service of Compline. It's a wonderful ancient monastic service of prayer that will be sung. It's a time when you can come and just sort of relax, conclude your weekend, and be in a place of peace and to just worship with us in letting that wonderful music of the ancient church and the Psalms wash over you. And every Tuesday and Thursday, we continue to have evening prayer at 6:30 p.m. brought to you from Clergy House. Our flowers this morning are given through the generosity of Rick Sensulo and Charlotte Borst in thanksgiving for their wedding anniversary. Now let us enter just a time of quiet and silence as we prepare to worship this morning. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. I was glad when they said to me, "Let us go to the house of the Lord." Lord, open our lips.
Our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Alleluia.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Come, let us adore him. Come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Come, let us adore him.
The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is loving to everyone, and his compassion is over all his works. All your works praise you, O Lord, and your faithful servants bless you. They make known the glory of your kingdom and speak of your power, that the peoples may know your power and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Your dominion endures throughout all ages. The Lord is faithful in all his words, and merciful in all his deeds. The Lord upholds all those who fall. He lifts up those who are bowed down. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The first lesson. A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 7, verses 15 through 25. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now if I do what I do not want, I agree that the law is good. But in fact, it is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is, not in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot do it. For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. Now if I do what I do not want, it is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. So I find it to be a law that when I want to do what is good, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God in my inmost self, but I see in my members another law at war with the law of my mind, making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am, who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Here ends the lesson.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Amen.
The second lesson. A lesson from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 11, verses 16 through 19 and 25 through 30. Jesus said to the crowd, "To what will I compare this generation? It is like children sitting in the marketplaces and calling to one another, 'We played the flute for you and you did not dance. We wailed and you did not mourn.' For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they say, 'He is a demon.' The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, 'Look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners.' Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds." At that time Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son of Man except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you who are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and I will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light." Here ends the lesson.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty,
creator of heaven and earth.
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Well, happy 4th of July weekend. I'm so glad you could join us today. I don't know about you, but I'm having a different experience of 4th of July this year. It's broader. And for me, it includes a celebration of Juneteenth, the part of the American story of freedom. And since I realized this change in me this week, Solomon Burke's song, or at least the chorus of it, "None of us are free," keeps going through my mind. If one of us is changed, none of us are free. So today, I celebrate the dream of the day when all of us are truly free. All of us. So let's pray before I share my thoughts with you. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come as holy fire and burn in us. Come as holy wind and cleanse us. Come as holy light and lead us. Come as holy truth and teach us. Come as holy life and dwell in us. Come as holy power and enable us. Convict us, convert us, consecrate us until we are wholly yours for your using. Amen. Next Sunday, we will begin our Adult Vacation Bible School study of the letter to the Romans. So with that in mind, I'd like to look at a portion of the Romans passage that we heard read to us just a few moments ago. I want to start with a story. It's a story about a pastor in a small neighborhood church. And his tradition was that at some point in the service, he would call the children up and have a little children's sermon with them. And so this particular day, he called the children up. They all settled around him on the steps to the altar. And he said to the children, "Children, if all good people are green and all bad people are purple, what color would you be?" There was a long silence. And just about the time he was thinking he'd have to come up with another prod, one little girl slowly raised her hand. Relieved, the pastor said, "Yes, Megan, what color would you be?" Took a little moment, and then she said, "Well, Pastor, I believe I'd be streaky." Megan's story is our story. We'd like to believe that we are all green and that they are all purple. But the fact is, we're all streaky. In today's Romans passage, Paul talks about his streakiness. His story is our story. He says, "I do not understand my own actions, for I don't do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate." He's streaky. Another way of talking about streakiness is to say we're all both shadow and light. Years ago, I heard a Bruce Carroll song called Shadow and Light. And the chorus of it still pops up in my mind, and I have sung it to myself hundreds of times. It gives me comfort. "I am shadow, I am light. I am wrong and I am right. Sometimes shining, oh so bright, sometimes fading into night. Though you see this war in me, you know all that I can be. I am precious in your sight. You walk with me through shadow and light." The truth is that we live with one foot in this world and one foot in the kingdom of God. We are citizens of the already and the not yet. We are shadow and we are light. Since the moment of our baptism, we set our feet on the journey to sanctification. With God's help, we began the process towards wholeness. And that transformation in us is already and not yet. Problem is that we resist acknowledging the not yet part of us. I'm quite certain that is because we fear God's response to our imperfection. Because many of us believe in a God of retributive justice, a God of an eye for an eye. And so we deny our brokenness for fear of God's punishment. The good news is that our God is not a God of retributive justice, but rather a God who leans toward restorative justice. Restorative justice is about healing, about helping people to be whole again. restorative justice gives us what we need, not what we deserve. Restorative justice listens to our confession, asking, what happened? What did you learn? How can I help you? What do you dream to be? Restorative justice helps us to achieve that dream. But there's a price to be paid for being willing to see our shadow, our less than perfect self. It can be overwhelming. That's what happened to Paul. He tried to do what was right and he failed, and he was overwhelmed. Wretched man that I am, he declares, who will rescue me from this body of death? In God's economy, the best day of our lives is the day we become overwhelmed at seeing our imperfections and feeling hopeless about them. It's the best day of our life if we take the next step. Paul did. Who's going to save me from myself? He asked. And the answer he came to is, thanks be to God through Jesus Christ. Our Lord was the answer. Ask any 12-step person. The first three steps of their program describes the exact same spiritual journey that Paul took. We admit we are powerless over alcohol and that our life became unmanageable. We came to believe that a power greater than ourselves could restore us to sanity. We made a decision to turn our will and our lives over to the care of God. Paul was doing the first three steps. And he lays out a pattern for all of us to deal with the areas in us that need to be transformed. First, we have to acknowledge what's broken in us and over which we are powerless. Second, we have to acknowledge that God has the power over that imperfection. And third, we have to ask God for help in our transformation. When we surrender our situation to God, God becomes our ally, our friend. God becomes a God who only desires the very best for us. We may get to the place Brother Lawrence did. When he failed, he confessed his fault, saying to God, I shall never be otherwise if you leave me to myself. It is you who must hinder my falling and mend what is amiss. There's a popular legend sometimes attributed to the Cherokee people. And in this legend, a child asks his grandfather to tell him a story. And grandfather tells him the story of the two wolves that are at war within each of us. The evil wolf is full of anger, envy, sorrow, regret, greed, arrogance, self-pity, guilt, resentment, lies, pride, superiority. The good wolf is full of joy, peace, love, hope, serenity, humility, kindness, generosity, truth, compassion, and faith. When the story was over, the boy asked his grandfather, which wolf will win? And the grandfather's answer was, the one you feed. On this weekend, when we celebrate the freedoms that some of us experience, and as we long for the promised freedom for every one of us, may we continue also to pursue the interior freedom that is available to all of us with God's help. May we continue to ask God to help us feed the good wolf. In Jesus' name, amen.
Once again, welcome to St. John's Cathedral on this Sunday morning. At this time, we invite you to give out of the generosity of your hearts as you are able for the maintenance of this congregation and for the mission of this congregation. Especially if you are a member of St. John's, we strongly encourage you to give of your abundance at this time. If you are visiting us, we encourage you to give to your own congregation if you have one first, and then if you have the ability out of your abundance to give to us as well, we would most appreciate those offerings. If you are not a member of any congregation, we invite you to come join us financially as well. With one exception, if today is the first day you are joining us at St. John's, we invite you please to be with us as our guest. Now walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God. Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come,
thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern and uphold them, now and always.
Day by day we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today.
Have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall never hope in vain.
O God, you have taught us to keep all your commandments by loving you and our neighbor. Grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit, that we may be devoted to you with our whole heart and united to one another with pure affection. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And look with pity, O Heavenly Father, upon the people in this land who live with injustice, terror, disease, and death as their constant companions. Have mercy upon us. Help us to eliminate our cruelty to these, our neighbors. Strengthen those who spend their lives establishing equal protection of the law and equal opportunities for all. And grant that every one of us may enjoy a fair portion of the riches of this land through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Lord God Almighty, you have made all the peoples of the earth for your glory to serve you in freedom and in peace. Give to the people of our country a zeal for justice and the strength of forbearance, that we may use our liberty in accordance with your gracious will, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. This time I invite you to offer your prayers and thanksgivings, either in your heart or aloud wherever you are, or by posting them on Facebook.
Pray for our bishops, John and Diane, and our canon to the ordinary, Melissa, that God may guide them and give them courage to move the Diocese of Los Angeles into a place of safety during this difficult time of pandemic. We pray for our president, that he might seek and serve Christ in all people.
Pray for all elected officials that they might have the wisdom to do that which they need to do in this time, that justice and peace might prevail, and that healing would come to our nation.
We offer God thanksgiving for the work of our food pantry and the work of our social justice committee here at St. John's.
Pray for all the sick of this parish community. And we pray for all of those who are ill with COVID-19 virus, that they might be healed. We pray for a cessation of this pandemic. And give us the forbearance to do those things which we know we must do for our own health and the healing of our neighbors. And now we bring all of these, our prayers and thanksgivings, all the longings of our hearts before the throne of thy divine mercy, O Lord, trusting that you are able, ever able, to do those things which we have committed unto you in faith. Amen.
God our Father, whose Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in a wonderful sacrament, has left us a memorial of his passion, grant us so to venerate the sacred mysteries of his body and blood, that we may ever perceive within ourselves the fruit of his redemption, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Blessed, praised, and adored be Jesus Christ in the most holy sacrament. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be God, the Holy Ghost, the Comforter. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Let us forever adore the most blessed sacrament. Praise the Lord, all you nations. Laud him, all you peoples. For his loving kindness toward us is great. And the faithfulness of the Lord endures forever. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Let us forever adore the most blessed sacrament.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore.
Amen.
Good morning, friends and family. Yesterday was one of the most important holidays we celebrate here in America. The 4th of July is our Independence Day. America won its priceless freedom through a revolution that included war. There are five essential documents that form the foundation of our democracy and express the spirit of America. An essay titled Common Sense by Thomas Paine. The Declaration of Independence. The Articles of Confederation. The United States Constitution and the amendments to the Constitution. All came into being between 1775 and 1789. My friends, have you read them yet? America's first leaders sought to forge a government that would serve the needs of the new nation and protect its democratic principles for the duration of the Republic. Again, hear me, please. The purpose of our government is to serve the needs of the nation and protect its democratic principles for the duration of our nation. So we, the people who actually are the government, are to serve and protect the citizens of the United States of America. My brothers and sisters, happy Independence Day. Together, however, we, the government, have work to do for ourselves, the citizens. Now, I pray that you are being realistic and practical about recognizing and respecting the challenges that we are currently experiencing. You do realize and acknowledge that there is a worldwide pandemic, COVID-19, that is killing people in unprecedented numbers in the United States. Activate your love and compassion for other human beings and put on your mask and maintain the 6 feet of social distancing. In many locations in our country, including Los Angeles, it's the law. Do you truly need a law to make you do what is right? Tell your own self and make your own self do what is right. Respect yourself so then you can respect everyone else. Value yourself so then you can value all others. Love yourself so then you can love every other human being, every single one. You and the world witnessed the murder of George Floyd, a black man, by Derek Chauvin, a white police officer in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Officer Chauvin kept his knee on the neck of Mr. Floyd for over 8 minutes, taking his life despite being recorded. We can even hear citizens imploring Officer Chauvin to stop. Since May 25th, our nation has been besieged with demonstrations. I have observed three kinds of demonstration participants: the peaceful protesters, the violent rioters, and the looters. It's a chaotic mixture that has caused death, injury, property damage, and property destruction. The bottom line, my fellow Americans, Mr. Floyd was denied yes, robbed of his rights as an American citizen. No arrest, no arraignment, and no trial with judge and jury. Officer Chauvin was his judge, his jury, and then carried out a sentence of execution. My brothers and sisters, in America, this is illegal. Now in America, we're experiencing a pandemic of health and a denial of human rights. A breach exists between us, the citizens, and the goals declared and fought for by the founders of our nation. The agreement, the laws, and the code of conduct are broken. I invite you to have faith, to fill yourself with hope. Democracy is an interactive system of government by the whole population through elected representatives. We, the people, are tasked to establish justice, ensure domestic tranquility, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, and secure the blessings of liberty to ourselves and our posterity. Remember, we are endowed by our Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Individually and together, we can and must repair this breach. In each and every election, vote. Vote like your life depends on it, because it does. The continued existence of these United States depends on your vote. Yes, we can restore America so it will serve and protect as intended. So my brothers and sisters, let's repair the breach. Complete the 2020 census and vote. This land is my land. This land is your land. Together, let's get busy. We have work to do.